This video is brought to you by Zarkin Productions, an umbrella group composed of over 10 YouTube shows, an archive of over 4,000 videos covering a wide variety of topics, and businesses both inside and outside of Second Life. Please go to zarkin.com for a complete listing of media links, follow us on Facebook and Twitter for our activity feed, subscribe to us on YouTube for future updates, and please support us on Patreon. Thank you for your time, and may I present another Zarkin production.
Child.
That's actually what proves to be that you're the liar.
How am I a liar? I had a great childhood. I didn't have to share nothing with any siblings.
Of course not, because you were forever alone. You didn't have any siblings. And I'm pretty sure you didn't make that many friends as when you were younger. Sure, when you got older, maybe when you were like maybe 10 to 13 years old, you had friends. But before that, you were just the weird kid in the playground.
I was not. I had plenty of friends.
You keep telling yourself that, but remember, Natas, I know the imaginary ones count for you, but in reality, they don't.
I don't know what you're talking about. They were real.
That's further proving my point.
Alright, ladies and gentlemen, grab a seat and quickly TP in everybody you know, because the show is getting ready to begin.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to DIE Deliverance. I am your co-commentator for tonight, the voice of sanity herself, Myra Murdoch.
And as everybody knows, I am the most recognized voice in SL Sports Entertainment today, the voice of Detroit, Natas Grimmore, and boy am I excited to be here.
I also had a very sad childhood, so let's just be a little sympathetic for him today, shall we?
Now, dear doctor. You know better than the project.
I can't help it. It's one of my charming natures. Charming traits, I should say. Oh, jeez. I'll do this one. Ladies and gentlemen, hailing here from Mexico City, Mexico, at a height of 6'4", weighing in at 460 pounds, dear God. It is Super Porky. I almost said 640, and then at that point, you'd think he'd be deathly obese. Morbidly obese by then.
Well, then that would be the fine line between damn and oh hell no!
I almost thought you said betwat. I was like, the toss, oh my goodness! You scandal!
As right now, he screams bacon.
Because who doesn't love bacon? I love bacon.
And that's why we, as you get older, you'll be as big as him.
Ouch. Remind me to kill you later. You never insult a woman about her weight.
Well, anyway.
Big no-no.
His opponent coming to the ring now. He hails from the graveyard, standing at 6'4", weighing in at 260 pounds. He is the Sinister, Cruel Nightfire!
And also former DIE champion. But, you know, a little tit for tat.
Are you really gonna rub it in his face?
Eh, just gonna enjoy it a little. Just to know that the both champion belts, championship belts, are out of LVD's hands.
Hi there, girl.
Do you remember to take your antipsychotics today? Or did you just say gum? Ow. A little harder, I would have thought it would be a smack. But I don't think he has a sense, a depth of perception.
You mean doesn't have a good depth perception?
Yeah, that. Sorry, this hot chocolate has a little extra few spirits in here. Catch my drift.
Does a gambit know that you're drinking on the table?
I don't know what you're talking about. I'm just drinking hot chocolate. Or coffee.
As you put it, with extra spirits.
Yeah, the Christmas spirit. Cause tis the season, right?
Right. As of course our officiate, we have Winter in the ring. Right now she's making sure that they are clear.
Yay.
Well, yeah, yes, Cruel, yes.
Put it nicely, yes.
I think that's his thing. As the bell rings.
I let the mayhem ensue.
Well, I'm sure that insulting his weight is not going to matter at this place. Right now, they lock up.
That's true.
As going in for that headlock and going straight for that headlock takedown, Cruel taking control. Linity, did you expect any less out of Cruel? Just saying.
No, not really. Because remember, this is Cruel we're talking about here.
As right now, though, Super Porky Gang up to a vertical base. And going right for that wrist lock.
Yes, Nathalia, it does have something to do with the arm, so you're close. Yes, it was the wrist lock.
Ha ha ha.
You didn't do it, sticker. As you know,
it's right
into that hammer
lock. Hammer lock.
No, I said it first. Shh.
Why are you whispering over there?
I don't know.
As right now, though, Cruel is wrenching on it. Now doing that forearm club.
God damn.
Bringing the big man down to a knee and manages to whip him across the ring there into the corner.
That does take actual skill in force, mind you. Imagine lunging 400 pounds into a corner. That has to be difficult. But I guess he totally means nothing as he comes charging towards Cruel now. Oh!
And gravity for that flesh eater! That triangle choke!
Probably tastes like bacon, which is a little gross.
As Cruel's telling him to tap! Wait a minute.
Uh-oh. Oh, God, no.
What?
Oh, jeez. It seems Cruel's trying to choke out Super Porky. It seems making his way out here. Is that really...
It looks like a Biden is up on stage making his way to the ring right now.
Oh boy. Knowing him, he's probably gonna try to murder Cruel as well. Oh, okay, not wasting any time.
Oh, was there that one punch laying out Cruel as a Biden and Ozzy are out here.
That had to hurt.
It looks like Super Porky... And Cruel ain't even moving.
Would be a dumb question to ask if he's alive.
Well, Winter had her back, so she didn't see him get one punch. But it looks like she's going to start the 10 count.
Well, Super Porky doesn't look like he's getting up, and neither does Cruel, so...
I mean, that flesh eater is a devastating chokehold, but right now, but getting that one punch, that one shot there by a big monster Abaddon, or Abaddon, excuse me, I can't seem to pronounce his name right either, but there's five, and Super Porky is making his way up to his knees. As he manages to get up, is he going to go for that pin? Or is he going to go... Oh, it looks like he's going to the corner.
Oh. Oh,
and
yeah.
Look out, this fat man's going to fly!
Oh, that's just being mean, Toss.
What? As he goes and does that Swanton bomb, all 460 pounds landing on Cruel.
God damn, he probably snapped a couple goddamn ribs like a twig. Holy hell.
There's one, there's two, and there is three. And your winner via pinfall is none other than Super Porky!
Wow. That says a lot.
Well, of course, he ended up getting help from Abaddon with that one punch. That big old hook right there to the jaw line. Okay.
It's all yours, buddy.
Are we really gonna tell him no? Looks like Cruel's getting back up, but...
Look at you. Walking away broken. You aren't even a zombie. You're nothing more but a broken, mortal man. Now I'm sure some of you have looked down the past few weeks while I've been seeing this one anarchy. The truth is, we see, we hear, we watch. Those are those of you that do not even deserve the positions you have! Those are those of you who would step on toes of others just to get ahead. Soon, chaos will rise and everything will burn to the ground.
Well then,
that was a little intense.
Well, I mean, look at the guy. He's an intense guy. But apparently, this turf war is, as you say, quite a few people here at DIE are walking on people to get ahead. I'm not sure who he's referring to, but, you know, it's a very broad assumption.
Yeah. Well then. I suppose it's safe to say we should move on to our next match of the evening.
I'm guessing before, so.
Before Abaddon comes out here and screams at us.
That's one thing I don't want.
Me either.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like, what are those
very
few
possible
people...
you might.
Yeah, this is one of those few people you never want to piss off.
Well, why don't you go ahead and take this one?
Of course. Ladies and gentlemen, hailing in from Springfield, Tennessee, at a height of 5'7", weighing in at 157 pounds, it is Rosa.
And what does she mean by no more shiny bracelets? I mean, normally if somebody mentions shiny bracelets, they mention handcuffs.
Damn, Natasha, I really don't want to know what you do on your Thursday nights.
I'm not talking about me, I'm talking about her.
Oh, look at you, you're so quick to fumble with your reasons.
And her opponent, hailing from the Eye of Terror, she stands at 5'10", weighing in at 165 pounds. She is the Agent of Chaos. Anarchy!
All in due time, Rosa. All in due time.
Where is Anarchy?
I couldn't tell you. Perhaps she's taking her sweet time.
Maybe. As Rosa says, come on, I don't have all day. I agree there.
There she is. Wait. No, that's not her.
Hey, we're the production series custom music.
This guy?
As we have Zachary Rage coming out.
Okay, first of all, I talked to the Gambit backstage, and this match has been cancelled.
Seriously?
It has been cancelled. And I have another announcement to make. This discussion mattered with Miss Rosalind. I am actually an attorney. Hired by her parents. Remember the fucking incident? It went too far.
Oh boy.
Your parents had to hire me to be your attorney.
Was it?
Hey, she says, more of a babysitter, you mean.
No, don't think of it that way. Just think of it... Think of me not only as a lawyer, but as an advisor. And don't worry, Di. I will be inviting a few wrestlers here with this so-called company.
Ouch.
Come on, Lulu, let's go to the back. We got something to discuss. But the match is cancelled.
I'm pretty sure we heard.
Well then,
it's weird.
Going to be advising a few wrestlers as he's once again hired by. It's definitely something that is kinda. I wonder, Gavin, are you worried about that?
Knowing him, I doubt it. Until at the last minute. Then he'll start frantically worrying about it. He probably had me to help. I would be like, alright, but I'm not that kind of doctor, but, you know. But anyway, folks, supposedly, you heard it here, this match between Anarchy and Rosa has been cancelled due to legal obligations, I suppose. Guess that's as good of a reason as any.
Now, would you like to go ahead and take care of the sponsors?
Yeah. Just give me a second. I think I fumbled my cards around here somewhere. Silly, silly me, you know. Sorry about that, folks. We do have a couple people to thank, folks. We have Jay Styles, Omega Raker Styles, Angel Dreams, Angelic Designs, Get Frocked, Hotspot Clothing by Candy Trice, as well as Bad Amplitude. I'm pretty sure they're having a concert this Sunday around 4 p.m. SLT, as well as an auction. It's like one of those, well, auction, I also heard. 4 p.m. SLT as well. Most likely with wrestling moves and all that such. As we also have Kittens, Candids, Kurosawa Builders Company Incorporated, and All for Your Wrestling Needs. Black Dragon Animations, Honey Blunt Designs, Big Baby Get Like Me Animations, Team Wildfire, Next Gen, as well as our brother Fed VWE.
Now that auction, now isn't that by Team Wildfire?
Yes. Sorry. Again, fumbling with my cards, and my brain was kind of eh. But yes.
And Team folks, Wildfire, there is, if you go up to the Wildfire vendor, you can see the moves that are being auctioned off, and you know, I suggest save your lindens because once again, you know, you can't beat that. You can't beat those. You know, you can't. Once they're gone, they're gone. There's only going to be one, you know, at the auction. So you save your lindens and get there. So, and yeah, how are you doing, Drake? I see that you are joining us on the comment table.
Oh, hi, Drake.
Yes, and it will be at the Career 7. Once again, I believe all that information is up here at the Wildfire vendor.
Yes. He needs to provide his own flashy advertisement. Not complaining. Just glad it's there because if you leave it up to me, dear God. Forget if I had a brain, you know, if it wasn't attached to my shoulders.
Well, you are a doctor for a reason.
Thanks, Natas. You make me ever feel so special.
You're
ever
welcome.
So special. Sarcastic.
Yeah, there we go. The headset's finally working. How are you doing,
I
Dr.
know.
Murdoch and Mr. Grimoire?
I'm doing fine.
How you doing? I'm doing pretty good
habit.
There, Drake.
Natas has this habit of stepping on people's auxiliary wires to where the headset starts fucking up. He has it happen, so don't worry about it.
Well, I can't help it. My legs are so long.
Then quit wearing heels, for God's sake.
I'm not wearing heels.
Are you sure?
Yes, I'm sure.
Anything more than 2 inches is heels, Natas. I'm looking at your shoes right now.
It is 1.5, thank you.
But anyway. Still heels.
They are platforms. They are not heels.
Okay, they're still heels. But ladies and gentlemen, hailing from Monmouth County, New Jersey, at a height of 5'10", weighing in at 187 pounds, it's Plasma.
And hey, they're making a comeback.
Yeah, I'm very interested in this match for obvious reasons. Plasma seems to have some sort of issue with me.
I don't know if it's
professional jealousy or what, but I see you, Plasma. I see you.
Hi! Oh, geez, he said hi. I was not expecting that.
How are you?
I think I was kind of sarcastic.
Nah, you think?
He doesn't have sarcastic depth perception, as he tried to correct me earlier.
I was just saying, and, you know, okay.
You say a lot of things, Natas. You do.
Alright, so hold up. I just got something to ask. That make me face who? What was his name? Natas. You remember what was his name, right? Who I was supposed to be facing tonight?
Huey50.
Who the hell is that?
He's so lovable. How can you not know?
He's a lovable Hawaiian.
Yeah. Hawaiian, my ass.
He's a legend in this business, rather than a snot-nosed punk like yourself.
Oh, fired. Talk about calling the kettle black, Drake?
Shots fired.
Whatever, bring him out. I'll make sure work on him.
Oh boy. I don't know, don't let his, you know, hearty, generous nature fool you. I'm pretty sure he has a little bit of a mean bone in his body. I think. I wouldn't know.
as he hails from Hawaii. He stands at 6'4", weighing in at 345 pounds. He is the lovable Huey 5-0.
Oh, he's going shimmy, shimmy, shimmy down the ramp.
Doesn't he always?
Yes. That's why I love the shimmy, shimmy. Shimmy, shimmy.
Well, me, by the sounds of it there, good doctor, you might be able to set up a private appointment with him.
You're trying to insult me. You better do it right, not sound like a stuttering idiot when doing so. A jealous one at that.
So, okay, fine. So, you a chubby chaser?
I don't know, Natas. I've been working with you long enough. I probably have gained the habit.
What do you mean I have it? I'm
you
not that big.
Okay, your words.
I'll have you know I am a fit, trimmed 195 pounds. Thank you very much.
All right, but I'll also remember you're not that big either. Gotcha.
Oh.
You said it, buddy, not me.
Sorry, I don't hang down to my knees like you do.
Oh, damn.
Okay, hold up. Wait a second.
Huey. That hurts.
Huey, what are you doing, man? What are you doing? We're not in Hawaii. I mean, these people don't even want to see you dance.
He's awesome when he dances.
I can't take you seriously, bro. I mean, seriously. I mean, look! I'm trying to face this dude, Drake Edwards, I'm trying to get a match with him for his title, and they booked me with you. I mean, seriously. I mean, at least Drake has some moves. Not much. I mean, don't even fly yourself, Drake. Trust me, you're horrible. But, I mean, you're Huey. Okay. I mean, you're just, what are you? Who are you? And what are you doing in this ring?
He's Hawaii.
I don't even know if he's even answering. Like, hey, is this man smart or anything? I mean, I just need to ask him.
As he goes for a quick schoolboy roll up.
Wow.
But Falcon was Death of the Plasma sat here and was a little
ran
quick.
His mouth as always. That's exactly what he did. Yeah. He almost got caught doing it.
Just a little bit.
I mean, did Plasma forget? Oh, it was a nice swinging neck breaker.
See, the thing with Plasma I don't get, he's got skill, but he's got such a bad attitude. And he's a cheap shot artist. I mean, you think you're going to impress me by attacking me from behind? Please.
I have a little bit of common decency when facing your opponent dead in the eyes.
Oh, speaking of high up, as Huey rolls him up again...
Tell you what, Plasma does not want to take Huey lightly. I mean, I've been in the ring with him. He's a legend for a reason.
Right?
Takes him lightly, he's going to get beat.
Dude, Huey's got that two count over him. Oh, he goes in for an elbow strike.
Yeah, exactly. I agree with the fan there. Is you can't take him lightly. I mean, look at him! 345 pounds there!
I was speaking figuratively. I mean, obviously, we see the physical attributes of Mr. 5-0.
But hey, if we're shooting for literal here, two birds with one stone, right?
Here we go in for that snap suplex. And another one just flinging Plasma around.
Just flung him like he was a sack of potatoes.
Yeah, that's right. Sack of taters.
So right now, Plasma manages to get up as he tries for it again, but Plasma stops and going in for that arm drag.
That was impressive. Gotta give credit where it's due.
I was actually surprised he came over with that arm drag and another one!
Like I said, Plasma's got skill, there's no denying that.
Sure, as he comes out of that corner, but oh!
That's the thing about it is Plasma is fast, and he's gonna have to utilize that speed and use it in moderation to get around Huey. Oh, as right now Huey goes for a kick but catches him and going in for that dragon screw.
It seems now he's grabbing one of Huey's legs and oh! Kicks it right in that thigh.
Oh, yeah, working his leg over.
Ooh, third
time. Very sad strategy here.
You take the legs from the big man, you cut him half the size. So would that make him, like, around the same, weight as, Plasma?
Probably soaking wet, maybe.
And so, it nailed Huey with that chop block. Working that leg one more time, trying to just looks like Plasma is trying to take out Huey's legs.
Oh, and he seems to be going for that figure four.
And right there in the middle of the ring.
Gee, thanks. There, guy. I just probably will take that as a compliment, because I'm pretty sure it's not.
Yeah, Plasma's got Huey in a bad way right here.
After taking all that punishment there, you know, I'm surprised Huey is lasting this long.
He's a legend for a reason.
Well, and he's looking to go... Looks like going for those ropes. Does he get him?
He got the ropes.
Yep, he's got the ropes.
But he's gonna wait till five, of course.
As right now, winner is starting the count.
I mean, I don't agree with Plasma's tactics here, but it's effective. It's very effective here.
Well,
I mean, he is at a huge disadvantage when it comes down to weight, let alone height. But I mean, take that, you chop down the trunk of a tree, and the tree will fall.
Obviously.
I think that makes sense.
Physics. kind of.
But Plasma comes running right into a belly-to-belly suplex.
Oh, that's bad. With you, that's bad.
X said you can never count Huey out. But the one thing, I just don't get what Plasma's attitude problem is. He's got so much skill, but he's so arrogant.
I think that's the curse within the gift, I suppose. Oh, is he whipping Plasma into that corner?
I mean, being skilled like he is, I mean, he knows it. Hence why, would probably be the reason why he's arrogant is, here comes Huey coast to coast.
Ooh.
And hitting him with that 340-pound splash.
I mean, yeah, he knows his skills. He's got his abilities, but there's this thing called class. Class.
He goes in for that clothesline.
Gets a full running start.
I see he's not going in for the pin. There's one. There's two.
as that he's getting up and, you know, does a little dance.
Shimmy shimmy.
Huey, we know that's your thing, man, but pay attention.
Right? At least, you know.
Finish him.
As they now off the ropes, they're going in for a huge splash, but Falcon getting out of, or Plasma getting out of the way.
Natas, did you hit your head this morning or something?
I think so.
I probably smacked him too hard earlier.
That's what it was. He just reminds me of somebody else.
Here, maybe this will rejaw your memory, perhaps, you know, help you a little.
Ow! Huey tried for a kick, but Plasma caught it. Oh, wait a minute. Tries for that enziguri, but Plasma gets you right in that ankle lock.
Plasma for great counter. Gotta give credit.
And right now, just great ring awareness there by Plasma.
I don't know how much more of this Huey can take.
Oh, it seems Huey tapped! Your winner, ladies and gentlemen, via submission, is Plasma. Aw, poor Huey.
Hold it. Come on, music, hold up. I'm still ready for one more. I'm still ready to go.
As you are you sure about that?
That was cake. That was cake.
Now, Plasma, let's not be stingy.
Oh no, don't even tell me anything about being stingy, gal. You see, there's been something selfish. There's been something that I've been eyeing. And that something is on your shoulder, my gentleman. Mr. Drake Edwards. Mr. Champ here.
He's calling you out, buddy.
So how about it? How about you do me a solid? And how
ladies?
About this?
Come on, ladies.
No. There ain't no come on, ladies, on this. You see, you have this guy who thinks he's a champion, but he ain't. A champion to these people, these fools? I mean, seriously, look around the ring, and look around the arena. Look who we have. We have, I don't know, some dude in a red hoodie. And who else we got? I don't know who that chick is. We got some person with a toy belt. And I don't even know who that guy is. I mean, seriously, who are these people? Who are these people? And why is he their champion?
Because he won it fair and square. You're talking about someone who went up against the living dead, for God's sakes.
They're dead for a reason!
Really? Plasma?
Exactly! What was it, Drake? What? That caused a nerf? That fucking nerf?
I'm right here, man. Face to face. What you want? What you got, man?
What's that? What the?
Facing and you can't do anything?
Uh-oh.
Oh, really? You really want to go out right now? Because I'll go out right now. I will freaking whoop the living hell out.
As we got a brawl right here.
Woo! Call it a dogfight? No, that involves planes. It's just a brawl.
Like flying to you. As right now, they're just brawling back and forth.
Yeah, you got him, Drake, that's right. Throwing that sucker punch.
As they know they're making their way, it looks like
they're fighting their way backstage. That's impressive. Just make sure y'all don't trip, you know. Alright then.
As they're just continuing the brawl.
Well then, y'all ladies are both pretty, you know, just for conversation's sake. Just saying. But anyway, yeah. As enjoying as I was, I probably should get myself situated, shouldn't I? Yes, I shall. Woo! Doop 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 doo.
Now, looks like I'm getting ready to conduct her interview.
Yep. Well, I'm pretty sure I'm throwing in a risk here without, you know, having the use of straitjackets or restraints of any kind. You know, I'm thinking these are everyday wrestlers, so why do we need restraints? Such silly things such as restraints. I mean, who needs those? Doesn't work on most people, so why use them in the first place? Hi, Winter. Yeah, that's besides the point. This chair doesn't like me. And of course, my lovely little patient, come out here. Don't be shy. Make yourself comfortable. I'm trying to, but this chair does not like me. I'm just going to be comfortable like this. Yes. I'm fine this way.
As though for sure, it looks like her.
Come now, Miss Doll. You've been interrupting a lot of my interviews, so might as well just put you in this godforsaken chair. Just to get it over with. Just to see if you kick the habit. Come now. Make yourself comfortable. Take a load off. The pillow looks comfy. Mind you, it looks comfy. I can't really guarantee if it is. Come on now, don't be shy. It's right there. The flat part you lie in. It's not a piece of meat. Oh, well, just make sure you get all of it off before you, okay. Anyway,
I had to sanitize that.
Yeah, bleach it or something. But anyway, Miss Doll, I just wanted you to come out here just to shed a little light on your little backstory, especially with the Living Dead. But first of all, we gotta set up a bedrock of all of this. And with that being said, what actually was your childhood like? I mean, was it in any sense a little bit of happiness in there? A little bit of joy, childlike wonder, if you will.
I remember being in a graveyard, but I was left by my parents, but they were killed by vampires.
By vampires?
Yes.
Well then, that makes sense. Alright, so you were left in a graveyard until a certain time by your parents. We were then killed by vampires. So I guess that goes with the follow-up question as to who actually raised you. I mean, were you on your own, or did you have someone there to look after you? I mean, it had to be pretty rough to be all on your own in a graveyard, especially at such an early age.
Well, I took care of myself for a long time, and then I found Cruel. And he showed me the way of being the living dead. I'm dead, you know?
Uh-huh. About that, Miss Doll. I do have some pictures of a certain place. I'm not sure if you recognize it, but do let me know if you do. Here. Do you recognize this place?
No. Not that place. Skrull saved me from there. No.
Really? Saved you from there. Alright. Do you see the girl in this photo? Striking resemblance, don't you think?
I see the girl.
The thing about this girl, though, she has actually been abducted from said facility. Whereabouts currently unknown. Nobody even knows what happened to her. Poof, off the face of the earth. What do you think that is, though?
That's Kitty.
Oh?
Mm-hmm.
And who is this Kitty?
A nurse.
Uh-huh. It's just peculiar in my mind how this particular nurse was the same nurse I am talking about who was abducted out of nowhere the same night you believe that Cruel saved you from this facility.
Don't you think
the coincidence is a little striking? It even tickles your mind a little bit. Now look closer at her picture. I'm pretty sure the picture itself would just come out and speak to you in ways you probably won't even understand, but in due time, my dear, it will. Look at the...
Oh my god, no, it's not true!
Sadly it is, my dear. I understand it's a lot to take in, but Miss Doll, you are actually Miss Kitty.
I am Kitty. I was a nurse.
There.
Get your ass out here. Explain this to me. How could you?
I seem to have started a little. Yes, I did. I couldn't help it. But, you know, it needed to be shed. The light needed to be shed. The clouds needed to be parted.
This is real. It's still fake. It's gotta be fake.
Sadly, Ms. Doll, it's all 100% legit. I took these actual copies from the facility themselves.
Cruel, get your ass out here! Or you'll never see Living Dead again!
Ooh, but that being said, I'm out. Yeah.
Yeah, it'd be probably a good idea there. Maya already get here to the table.
Mm-hmm. I can't help but instigate this kind of mischief. It's my nature. But I felt that she deserved to know, at least.
Oh, so you decided to shock her back into reality and break her fantasy?
Yes, because who needs subtlety? It's overrated.
Oh, now, as she calls Cruel, he's making his way down here.
Ooh, he's in trouble. No, for real, he is. He is in trouble. Legitimately wise, he is.
Because of you?
No, it was the abduction. But, you know, I guess a little bit it was me.
How could you? I took care of you! I loved you! And took care of you!
Ooh. Tension so thick you get. Oh shit!
Oh!
Oh, okay.
Wow.
Hell hath no fury, I suppose.
But did you see that never mess with women? Just yes. Leveled him!
Well, yeah. Like I said, ladies and gentlemen, hell hath no fury. Like a very confused woman. Oh, and Jesus Christ, now she's just stomping away on him.
Kinda looks like on his manhood.
Well, what was left of it, I suppose.
Now I don't know if she's picking him up. Oh, but wait a minute, Cruel comes back and kicks her. I can't say as I blame him after that smack and kick to the groin.
Right. Wow. But to him actually hit a woman. You know? Now I'm not really surprised as to... Uh-oh.
Oh, wait a minute. Oh, power shit! Bombs. Power bombs that doll. I guess that she now that she remembers, he no longer has any use for her?
Wow. Now I really feel bad. Yeah. Guilt slowly starting to set in.
Are you sure that's guilt?
I'll let you know later. Well, deep down, I felt she needed to know. I mean, I've actually been doing this research for a couple of months now, and to finally find this photograph that actually solved it all, you would think I would actually enjoy the ending of it, but I don't.
Well, I don't think you should be proud of yourself.
No, that's not what I'm feeling, but I'm not really feeling guilt either. I suppose this is what happens when you try to go for the bad boy thing that your mother warns you about. Yeah, I think that's it. Maybe.
Right now, yeah, you did. Her back's hurting. You did a great job. Her reality shattered.
I'll talk to her when she's feeling better.
Oh boy, folks. I don't know what this means for Living Dead, but you know, I guess we'll have to wait and see.
Right. This is why I don't usually do the right thing, because it usually backfires like this and it makes me look like the asshole.
Oh, apparently that is the case.
Thanks.
But
see you, Natas.
Thanks. Anyway, folks, are you ready?
Yeah, I kept it. I'm sorry. I couldn't help it. The way you said it, are you ready? I just thought of SpongeBob for some reason.
You thought of SpongeBob when I said that.
Yeah. Look, are you ready, kids? Oh, yeah, Captain. Alright, I'll just shut up.
Ugh. Oi. As I promised.
Here we go.
As I said, Santa Hippo is here. Alright, folks, to get your free gift here, all you need is click on the bag.
Alright. Because I'm pretty sure he enjoys you clicking on his sack. His sack of goodies. Yeah. Go on, folks, don't be shy. Because it itself is the gift that keeps on giving. Yeah.
Never mind. What?
You know what. And you know why.
No, I don't. What'd I do?
Oh, never mind. If you really legitimately don't know, then I guess I'm not really that sorry. That's so funny. You're probably due for one in the future anyway. Want a cupcake?
Yeah.
There's a chocolate one. And there is a blueberry one.
All I'm gonna say to you is grr.
Aw, but it's a cupcake. Don't you want a cupcake? Come on. Can't stay mad forever.
You just want to smack me, don't you?
No, not at this particular moment. No, I want to savor that for a very rainy day. Wallet. Aren't our Christmas lists looking a little exotic? Looking your way, Trish.
Anyway, as we are going, getting ready to go into our main event. Go ahead and introduce the first combatant.
I have to. Ladies and gentlemen, hailing in from the other side of the tracks at a height of 5'11", weighing in at 180 pounds, it's that guy who sleeps in the back. It is Hobo Bob!
Who?
Hobo Bob.
Yes. He's probably sleeping again.
Somebody needs to go back there and wake him up.
With a fire hose.
Hobo Bob. There we go.
Hobo Bo Bob.
As now we've got some other guy looking for a hot dog.
And come on, make your way into the ring. No need to be hassling people for hot dogs. We really don't want to know what you'd do for a wiener. I know you are. But you're in a match. For God knows what reason. And folks, I wouldn't really recommend feeding Hobo Bob, really. I can't really be honest to say he has all of his shots.
Seems that the Gambit's being a little generous.
Of course, if he has some guy in a Santa suit come out giving out free stuff to people, might as well give a hobo a shot at a wrestling match. Seems fair. I just hope he doesn't try to stab Omega with that stick of his.
I'm afraid what's in his knapsack. But anyway, hailing from New York City, he stands at 6'10". Well, 6'11", weighing in at 300 pounds, he is James Omega Ricker!
Alright, shut the music off, shut it off. Is management kidding me? Are they kidding me? This hobo loser, huh? Alright. I'll give him his less than 15 minutes of fame. You're a dead man.
Oh boy. Like I said, folks, we might be witnessing a murder tonight as our main event! So I hope you all got your umbrellas and your raincoats ready, because this one's going to be messy.
As he's still looking for hot dog.
Oy vey.
Be a star.
Show tolerance and respect.
And there goes the bell, ladies and gentlemen. Starting off this main event, which I know it's a little unorthodox, but again, we've explained the Gambit has some sort of overwhelming generosity in his heart to where he believes that, oh, let's put Hobo Bob against one of our, you know, powerhouses of the roster. Oh, and already locking up and shoving down Hobo Bob like nothing. And he's shaking.
As right now, though, Omega picks up Hobo Bob. And then whips him into the rope. As right now, he's starting to stomp him. As right now, Hobo Bob sits up. And oh! As Ray, he's going for the pin, but no, Omega picks him up.
Wow, I think he probably thought it was too easy of a win to just get the three count already. And by mistake, I had the mute button on. Silly me. Like I said, I would forget I had a head if it wasn't attached to my shoulders.
I don't think I did anything.
I didn't say you did. Completely innocent for once. See, now throws Hobo Bob into the ropes, charging back at him. I'm pretty sure that's going to be the biggest mistake of his life as he goes in for that big boot. But what's this? Hobo Bob actually managed to roll under it. Oh, tries going for that drop kick, but didn't do anything.
Oh, I mean, he is saying he's hungry. Maybe that's affecting his strength.
Right?
Maybe the,
As he tries to drop kick his ass, and literally has no effect, into his stomach, and only pushed him back oh so far.
No, at least he's learning to use that weight, is going for that drop kick again. See, I told you he had some fighting skill.
Yeah, well, you're the one who doubted him in the first place, and just charges back at Omega. Oh, and goes out with a heavy elbow smash. Completely throwing down Hobo Bob and whatever momentum he happened to build at that moment. That, ouch. Oh, as he goes in for that... Goes in for that cover. There's one. There's two. But no, actually picks him back up again. No, Mr. Rage, that was two. There's one and two. Only two.
I don't think your client there is actually, he calls for a hot dog.
Like I said, we really don't want to know what he'll do for a wiener.
You know, I'm not even going to entertain that thought. Is right now, Hobo gets up.
Uh-oh. Omega going for that million-dollar dream right onto Hobo Bob, forcing him to take a knee. Oh boy. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, the wager's up! How fast will Hobo Bob pass out from lack of oxygen? Do I hear 2 minutes? But it seems out in the crowd, they're trying to cheer on Hobo Bob as they're telling him to do it for the hot dogs!
As right now he's trying to wiggle out of it. As it looks like the fans are trying to get behind him, yelling aim to hot for hot dog.
Wow, you really know it's bad if, you know, people are going for Hobo Bob than Omega. At least on Uh-oh. Oh damn, and he's out! Your winner, ladies and gentlemen, via knocking him the f out, is James Omega Ricker. I guess he's not getting any hot dogs. Wow, he just dropped like a sack of taters.
Well,
I'm pretty sure I can't really say sack
of wieners. He'll enjoy a sack of taters.
Nah, I'm pretty sure he'll prefer wieners. Just power hose him, winner, and he'll probably wake up. Maybe. Hi, Omega. It's right there! I'm gonna yell. Jeez. Got feelings, you know.
You do?
Besides the points. Shut up.
Alright, shut it off. I'm not done speaking. That's better, dummies. So management decided to put me up against this loser prick, filthy ass hobo. Well, next week, I better get a better opponent. Because if I don't get a better opponent, I can't say that a certain person with a title will be here. Now, I'm out of here to get this stupid, ugly stench off this hobo loser off of my body. I'm out. And you shut up, Bear. Goddamn sick of you.
Ah, there's nothing like arguing with the audience, but wow, he's already making death threats as to wanting a better opponent next week, unless something really bad's going to happen to Drake.
Well, it looks like we've got Omega gunning for, you know, the title back, and then we have Plasma gunning for Drake. It's like I always said, though, once you get that title, you got a target on your back.
It comes with a job, I suppose. Wouldn't you say in this kind of line of work, Natas? Hell, you of all people would know.
What do you mean I would? I've never held a title.
I'm talking about a target on your back, stupid.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, you know damn
Everybody
well.
Loves me.
If you want to call that love, then dear God, I would hate. I tell you hate to see what people would do to you if they hated you. Just say it. But anyway, folks, that was our main event as cringing and dear God, as horrible as it was. That horrible isn't bad, just horrible isn't a horror kind of nightmare kind of thing. Pretty sure we thought you died there, Bob. But you might want to take a shower. Alright, yeah. Or go for hot dogs. Whatever works. But anyway, folks, as I said, that was our main event. as Omega's already issuing threats as to wanting a better opponent, or else Drake is going to get it. Dear God, as if he doesn't have already enough targets on his back. Already having plasma on his ass, too. Anyway, I have been your co-commentator for tonight, ladies and gentlemen, the voice of sanity herself, Byron Murdoch.
And I have been your second commentary for the evening, the most recognized voice in SL Sports Entertainment today, the voice of Detroit, Natasha Scrimmore.
Who does not English good, by the way.
No, I blame her.
You're a dick.
But anyway, folks. Go ahead.
Oh, really? Are you sure? Are you just going to tell them how awesome you are? Okay, thank God. Join us next week, same time as ever. We'll see what happens then. Maybe Omega will fulfill his promise, quote unquote. Or who knows at this point. We won't know until next week. So, ladies and gentlemen, until then, good fight. Good night.